Welcome to this session. Today we want to study vestigial sideband transmission. The learning outcome of this topic is, at the end of the session, student will be able to explain the concept of vestigial sideband transmission. The contents of this topic is, first, introduction. Video signal is formed modulating components and the rest of the signal. Out of that one, first one is modulating components having the very low frequency and it rises to sidebands very close to the carrier frequency. Sidebands are difficult to remove by physically releasable filters. Thus, it is not possible to fully suppress one complete sideband in the case of television signal. Therefore, the low video frequency contains the information of the picture. Completely suppress the lower sideband would result in distortion at these frequencies. This distortion is seen by this eye. It is called as shimmer in the reproduced picture. Therefore, only part of the lower sideband is suppressed. Means here you cannot suppress fully lower sideband. You suppress only the few parts of the lower sideband. Because if you suppress the fully lower sideband, that type of a filter we cannot be designed or we cannot be offered. Therefore, the radiated signal now become as upper sideband and carrier and vestiges. This vestiges is formed as removal of a lower sideband and which is to be remove that part and remaining that part is called as a vestiges part. Therefore, now the signal is ready for radiation and transmission. That transmitted signal now contains upper sideband, carrier signal and vestige signal. This pattern of a transmission of the modulated signal is known as vestigial sideband or FIC transmission. In the 625 line system, which are we use in India, that is the 625 line system, that is the frequency up to 0.75 MHz in the lower sideband are fully radiated. Therefore, the net result become for transmission or whichever we radiated the signal is normal double side transmission for the lower video frequencies and the main body of the picture information. The main body of the picture information means that it contains the message and the normal double sideband transmission means it contains upper sideband and the lower sideband having the removal part of that one and remaining part. Now, recall, wait for, pause the video for few minutes and think on this question and write down answer in your book. Is it possible to terminate the bandwidth of a signal abruptly at the edge of the sideband? The answer is no. Because filter design is difficult, standard filter design is difficult. That's why we cannot bandwidth of a signal abruptly at the edge of the sideband. We cannot terminate. Therefore, an attenuation slope of 0.5 MHz we require. A loss in horizontal detail is occur if attenuation slope were not allowed and any distortion at the higher frequency end, then only horizontal loss will happen. Since the high frequency components of the video modulation determines the amount of horizontal details in the picture. Now, this figure shows total bandwidth using vestigial lower sideband. This figure shows 625 line system of the vestigial sideband. Now, vestigial sideband means what we can understand with the help of this diagram. See, there are two parts of the upper sideband. This one is upper sideband, one is a lower sideband. And now we transmit the full upper sideband, no problem. And for the vestiges means for the saving the bandwidth, we remove the parts of LSB. We cannot remove the full part because that type of a filter we cannot design. That's why we remove the lower part of the LSB. Therefore, the total now become as total channel bandwidth become as 7 MHz. Now, in the previous lecture, we studied the total requirement for that one 11 MHz. Now, we reduce that one up to 7 MHz. Now, this graph is drawn amplitude versus frequency. Now, this LSB. Now, if you observe this diagram, the total channel bandwidth is 7 MHz. Up to that one, the picture carrier is at present 5.5 MHz and the sound carrier is present at the 0.5 MHz and the guard band is 0.25 MHz. In this way, the total channel bandwidth requirement is what? 7 MHz. And we save 4.25 megahertz in this band space. Now, figure 1 illustrates the saving of band space which results from Vestigal sideband transmission. The picture signal is occupy a bandwidth of 6.75 megahertz instead of 11 megahertz. Now, the second part is transmission efficiency. The total power that is developed and radiated at the transmitter, the total power is equal to carrier power plus the power in the two sideband. Means total power is equal to the summation of carrier power plus the power in the two sideband, means upper sideband as well as lower sideband. Therefore, the above equation become as PT is equal to, that is a total power is equal to PC, that is carrier power, plus the power in the two sidebands, that is in upper sideband, power in the upper sideband and the power in the lower sideband. Now, put that values of the carrier power and two sideband power, that equation 1 become now as PT is equal to EC square by 2R plus M square EC square by 8R plus M square EC square by 8R. Means here, this is a what carrier power, this is a what upper sideband, this is a lower sideband power. Now, where AC by root 2 is the RMS value of the sinusoidal carrier wave. R is the resistance in which the power is dissipated. Now, equation 2 can be now simplified as, in terms of we simplify that equation 2 PC. PC means power in carrier. Then, therefore, the above equation 2 become as PT is equal to PC plus M square by 4 PC plus M square by 4 PC. Now, again, we simplify this equation, then the equation become as PT is equal to PC in bracket 1 plus M square by 2. Now, if we keep the constant, the carrier power, then the transmitted power PT is purely depend on this M. M means modulation index. Now, as M increases, this transmission power increases. The maximum value of M is 1. This value of M is ranged between 0 to 1. Now, suppose if we calculate the maximum transmitted power, then the value of M is also what? Maximum. Why? Because the transmitted power is directly proportional to the M, and if M is equal to 1, then the power at that time transmitted power is high. The from equation 3, PC remains constant, but PT depends on the value of the modulation index M. Total modulating voltage is equal to the square root of the sum of the squares of the individual modulating voltage. From the equation 3, at 100% modulation, M is equal to 1, the transmitted power attains the maximum possible value. Therefore, when we put the M is equal to 1, that above equation become as transmitted power maximum is equal to 1.5 PC carrier power, where the power content in the two sideband has a maximum value of 50% of the carrier power. So the carrier component is redundant. In the transmission, when we calculate, then 72% of the total power that is radiated in the double sideband and full carrier wave in the M system, that is full carrier wave, is called as A3 modulation. Now, economy can be affected if the carrier power is suppressed and not be transmitted. Suppression of a one sideband result in more economy and also house the bandwidth requirement for transmission as compared to A3. SSB, single sideband, is used to save the power and bandwidth in mobile communication system, and SSB is used in mainly in the telemetry, radio navigation and military application also. In all the TV systems, we use full carrier is radiated and we use vestigial sideband transmission is used for TV transmission. Now, complete channel bandwidth. The sound carrier is positioned at the extremity of the full radiated upper sideband. The sound carrier is 5.5 megahertz away from the picture carrier. Since it makes for minimum interference between the two signals, that's why it always keep away from 5.5 megahertz away from the picture carrier. The frequency spectrum is equal to plus or minus 75 kilohertz. Guard band will require 0.25 megahertz. Therefore, total channel bandwidth for the TV system is 7 megahertz. And in the previous lecture, we studied the total bandwidth required is when we not using the vestigial sideband 11.25 megahertz, but when we use the vestigial sideband for the transmission of a television, we require only 7 megahertz. Therefore, the band space save we saved with the help of when we transmit in the vestigial sideband, then 11.25 megahertz minus 7 megahertz equal to 4.25 megahertz. That means we save 4.25 megahertz, that much amount we want to save in the for the transmission in the TV signal. Now we take an example here. This example, we now studied the example of different countries. We use different countries, and out of that was the first country, which was India. In India, we use this signal that we show the CCIR TV channel sideband spectrum, and C is the color subcarrier frequency. This type of a total channel bandwidth use of in India we use. This graph is drawn amplitude versus the frequency. And if you observe this diagram, it will start from the zeroth. The picture is start from the zeroth frequency, and it will reach up to the picture information is up to in bit 5.5 megahertz. And the color subcarrier is in between the 4 to 5 megahertz. And this is sound which is present at a 5.5, and sound signal sideband we require for in India, this is 150 kilohertz. Therefore, total channel width when we use vestigial sideband requirement is 7 megahertz in the India we use. And this is a lower sideband 1.25 megahertz, and this is a 1.25 we use lower sideband for in India. Now again, for the UK, there is again 625 line system for the TV channel standards we use, but here total channel bandwidth for the UK is 8 megahertz. Out of that one, 6 megahertz is used for the picture transmission, and this color subcarrier is present at 4 to 5 megahertz. This upper picture sideband required is 5.5 megahertz, 0.75 this megahertz is separation. Here guard band is 0.25 megahertz, and this again the vestigial LSB we require here lower picture sideband is 1.75 megahertz. This is an example where we use in UK. This is an example we use in America, that is 525 line system TV channel standards. Here again it will shows the diagram amplitude versus the frequency. Here we use total channel bandwidth is 6 megahertz. Out of that one, 4.5 megahertz is used for the picture, and color subcarrier present at the from 0 to 3.58 megahertz, and this is a sound carrier is present at 4.5 to 4.75 megahertz, and this is sound signal spectrum totally 75 kilohertz is required in America. This 0.25 megahertz is used for guard band in this America, and the remaining part 0 to 1.25 is required for lower sideband. We use this type of pictures in America. So in this way we studied the example in India, in UK and in America, and the requirement of a different bandwidth is for different countries is different, and we studied with the help of this diagram. This sideband spectrum of two adjacent channels of the lower VHF band of television station is allocation is shown here. This is a band 1 channel 4, and this is a band 1 channel 3. These are separated by this guard band, and we draw this graph amplitude versus the frequency. This is a first band channel, and this is a second band channel. We transmitted one after the other, and these two are separated with the help of this guard band is shown, and requirement of this total channel bandwidth is 7 megahertz including the guard band. The references for this topic is